Hi, this is Char from The Real Kitchen for Real People, and I trust that everyone is doing well, and we have an exciting summer dessert here today, and we're going to feature the pineapple coconut pound cake, and this is a cake that was always prepared and ready to serve at my mother dear's house, my husband's grandmother. And she always would have this pound cake ready when we came to visit. So I want to share this masterpiece recipe with you guys. Now first, I have already put in my mixing bowl 3 cups of sugar. Okay, so 3 cups of sugar goes into your mixing bowl. And in here, we're going to put 3 sticks of butter. 3 sticks of butter will go in this bowl. And it needs to be soft butter, room temperature, not melted, but room temperature butter. You want to make sure you get all that butter off of your packages. Okay. Gonna be 3 of those, and this is definitely not a diet cake, that's for sure, but she always would say eat in moderation. You don't have to eat a big slab all at once. You just slice you off a small amount and eat. You don't have to overeat. Even if it is a fattening cake, you can eat small portions at a time. But if it doesn't fit your diet plan, then this is not the cake for you. Okay, now that you have your butter and your sugar in your mixing bowl, you're going to mix this for about, I would say, 12 minutes in the mixing bowl. Because you want to make sure your butter and sugar is whipped really well. And that's very important when you're making a cake. It's usually always cream your butter and sugar first. And when you do, make sure you cream it long enough to where you don't feel the gritty in your mixture. So I'm going to mix this for 12 minutes and you do the same. And in between the 12 minutes, you want to stop it and scrape your sides. Just kind of push your sides down. All that butter and mixture on the sides, you want to make sure it's incorporated as well. So I'm pushing those down. And continue blending. Medium. Okay, I turned it down on low. And you can see how whippy it is. Fluffy. See in there? Okay. And it's not gritty. So it took about 15 minutes, let it blend for about 15 minutes. And this is one of the most important parts of baking any cake, is making sure your sugar and butter is creamed properly. Now I'm going to add 5 eggs to this mixture, but I'm going to add them one at a time, beating after each one. turn the blender up to the next notch. Blending about 2 minutes after each egg. And do this until you add all of your eggs. Okay, scrape your sides all the way around. Make sure that they scrape around good. In this bowl, I have mixed together 3 cups of all-purpose flour and 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And what I'm going to do is sift this into another bowl to make sure that it'll be nice and fluffy. Here's the sifter, and this is my mom's old sifter. So that means a whole lot to me. Okay, I'm going to add my flour mixture, which is 3 cups of all-purpose flour. So I'm going to add 1 cup at a time and sift. You may have a different type of sifter, but this is my mom's. So I enjoy using it. And this just helps your flour to be a little bit thinned out and makes your cakes a lighter weight. See, it's just a little basket. And some people have a little strainer that they use. But whatever you use, and you can see the difference in the sifted flour versus the flour that's not sifted. So I'm going to show you. This is the sifted flour that I just sifted. And this is what I have to sift. See how fine the sifted is? Okay, so I'm going to sift the other 2 cups in this mixture. Okay, I finished sifting my flour. I have 3 cups of sifted flour in now, and 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt is in this bowl. Okay, now I'm going to add this flour mixture into my butter mixture alternately with my milk. So I'm going to alternate, put a little bit at a time, mix, and put milk. Now, the milk, I have 1 cup of skim milk. Now, you can use any kind of milk that you desire. You can use buttermilk in this recipe, or just regular whole milk, or whatever you desire. But in my recipe, I am using 1 cup of skim milk. And then as I add, I don't want to overbeat, just add it enough to where it kind of mixes in a little bit. You don't have to beat it like you did the butter and sugar at the beginning. You don't have to do that long. because it may cause your cake to fall. Okay, so we're going to add the flour mixture alternately with the milk, little at a time. Last portion of my flour. And the last portion of the milk. And I'm going to kind of scrape this so that's down. Continue mixing. Okay, this is how my batter looks. Looks nice and creamy. And now you need to preheat your oven at 325 while you finish the rest of your cake mix. Okay, I'm going to give that a stir. By hand. And then I'm going to add my... I don't have any pineapple flavoring. So I'm going to use orange. If you have neither, you can use vanilla. So I'm going to stir in that. And that is a teaspoon of orange, pineapple, or vanilla flavoring. Okay, that's my teaspoon of orange flavoring. You can, like I said, you can use whichever one you want, the vanilla or orange. And if you can't find pineapple, I can't find pineapple at any store. So I'm going to use what I have, which is orange or vanilla. Okay, see how that looks? Nice and fluffy. Okay. Okay, now I'm getting ready to drain my crushed pineapples. So I just have a strainer here, and I'm going to drain this juice off my pineapples because I want to save that juice later. So you just hold it in there and drain it all off. sure you get your pineapple drained really well. And do this until all the juice is off your pineapple. Okay, now my pineapples are all drained, and I'm going to fold these into my cake batter. So I'm going to fold these in, the pineapples into the cake batter a little bit at a time. I know this seems like a lot of work for pound cake, but believe me, it is well worth it. It is so good. And it makes you appreciate your grandmother and your mother always having a homemade dessert ready when you come, because it is a major job to do. It's not easy, so they had to put a lot of love into preparing these desserts for their family. And you realize that once you start making them yourself. But out of all the hard work, it is still wonderful and rewarding. So I'm going to blend those up in there. Just fold them up lightly in there. Okay. And then I am going to add a fourth cup of coconut. And I'm going to fold it in as well. And that was a large can of drained pineapples, crushed. Be sure to get the crush. That's a large can of crushed pineapples. So now I'm going to add in 1/4 cup of coconut and stir that in. And like I said, if you are on any kind of health or weight program, then this may not be the cake for you. So, it is rich and delicious. But the thing I've learned is to just eat in moderation. Just don't overdo it when you eat anything, not just desserts, but anything. So this is how your cake batter will look. And now I'm going to let this sit and rest while I grease my cake tub pan, the tube pan. So I'm going to use a tube pan that I received as a gift from my cousin in California. Him and his wife sent me this beautiful cake pan with the design. So I'm going to give it a try. So I want to grease this really well because it has a lot of designs in the bottom of it. So I'm going to grease that really well with butter, and then I'm going to flour it, and then I'll back. Now I have my pan floured and ready to go. I'm going to spoon my batter into my pan. Until I get it all the way around evenly. Try to do it as even as possible. And you just spoon this in or pour it in, whatever's easier for you. I like to spoon mine in until I get kind of at the end, so I won't make such a big mess pointed in this tube pan. Just takes a little bit more time, but it's worth it. And I hope you guys make this let me know how you made it your own masterpiece, what you add to it, because that's what makes fun, cooking fun, is just adding extra ingredients to make it your own. So that's I enjoy showing you. I enjoy teaching cooking. And so I hope you enjoy learning or just watching, period. And you see how that's coming together pretty evenly. Getting pretty close to the end, so then I'll just pour that in. Okay. And spoon that in until you get all of your cake batter. And you kind of want to shake it a little bit to just settle your batter into your pan. Okay. And I always put, when I'm making a pound cake, I always put a cookie sheet in there because sometimes it wants to overspill and I don't want that all on my oven. So I usually set the two pan on top of the cookie sheet in the oven. And we're going to bake this on 325, as I said, and it's going to bake for about an hour and a half until your toothpick goes into your dough and it comes out smooth. So, I'll see you back in an hour and a half. Okay, my cake is done and I've taken it out of the oven. And what I'm going to do is let it rest here for about 5 minutes. And in the meantime, I'm going to mix together my glaze while this cools before I take it out of the pan. Okay, I have... I'm going to use 1 cup of my powdered sugar, and I'm putting that in a bowl. Just pour that in the bowl, 1 cup. And this is going to give you your glaze. Then you're going to add just a little pineapple juice. You know the pineapple juice that you had drained. I want to just maybe take a tablespoon of that just first and pour that into my powdered sugar. Okay, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of melted butter. Mind you, this is not an icing and a frosting. This is just what you call a glaze. It's just going to be drizzled over the top of your cake. I'm going to add just a little more pineapple. That's real good. And it don't have to be real loose at this point. This is about how you want it, because once it hits that cake, it'll kind of melt anyway. But that's how it'll look. And that's going to be your glaze. I think I'm going to add just a little orange flavoring to there. I'm going to add a half a teaspoon of orange flavoring. Give it a little kick there. And then I'll stir that. Okay. recommend you, if you don't have orange or pineapple flavoring, just use your vanilla flavor. Okay, now we'll go over here and attempt to take this cake out of this fancy pan. Okay, it's been sitting 5 minutes, so what I do is just take a knife and just kind of ease around the edges. Just ease, push it forward. Go all the way around. And before I turn it over, I'm going to shake it a little bit, just kind of get the air down, and it kind of helps your cake not to stick to the pan. Okay, so what I do, I've got a plate here, and I'm going to flip this plate over the top of the cake like this, just turn it upside down, and then flip your cake over into your cake. See, now you flip your pan over into your plate. Just kind of wiggle with it, Lord. Don't rush it. And I'm going to let that sit there like that for about 5 minutes. Okay, after your 5 to 10 minutes of cooling, I've taken the cake out of the pan, and it stuck a little bit there on the side. But it looks delicious. So now I'm getting ready to put the glaze on it. Okay, I wanna get ready to put my icing on. And if your icing has stiffened up, you can add just a little bit more of your pineapple juice. Just a little bit, like a teaspoon at a time until it's loosened up. Like that, to that consistency. Okay, so we're gonna do this with the cake. Just we'll run it around. And it'll drip around the sides on its own. Don't that look delicious? Just gorgeous. And like I said, this is not something that you can just eat a lot of at once. You have to spread it around. So this will last us for at least a week. And I'll share it with others. But don't that look good? Mm-hmm. Looks real good. And you'll get some runoff. But once you get through putting your glaze on there, you can clean around the sides of your plate. You see how that glaze just melts on there? You could take some of it off the side and drizzle it back up on there. Because it can make a mess. And there is your pineapple coconut pound cake. Isn't that cool? gorgeous, and it is going to be delicious. So once you have ice in your cake, then just kind of let it rest for at least a couple of hours before you dig in. Because it seems like pound cakes to me taste their best the next day. But I'm not going to be able to wait till the next day. I'm going to have to try a piece today, and then I will plate it and let you see how moist and soft and fluffy this cake is. Okay? Okay, I am getting ready to cut a slice of this out. And to be honest, I already had sliced it and tasted it, and it was so good. So this is my husband's piece. And it is so soft and light. Now that's the pineapple coconut pound cake. Doesn't that look beautiful? And just to show you how light it is, I cut it right there. See how light that is? And it is fantastic. I guess I'll sneak that piece. That was so good. So be sure to try this marvelous cake. It is delicious. And I guess I'll save that for him. But be sure to thumbs up if you like it. And let me know what extra ingredient you add to your pound cake. If any. But like I said before, enjoy your day, and I'll talk to you next time. Love, love. Enjoy.